monthly segment, filling us in on how to watch your favorite NBC shows on Netflix and to update us on what's new on the service in June. She is one of America's most recognized and trusted television personalities and an award-winning journalist and best-selling author. She joins us today from New York City. Joan, thanks for being here. Okay, so last month, you told us about a few NBC shows that we can stream on Netflix, like Law & Order, SVU. What are some other shows from NBC that we can watch now?
Really hit shows from your network, like Parenthood and The Good Place. Those are now, all the episodes are over on Netflix. But also, if you like those shows, you should try a show called Gilmore Girls, A Year in the Life. And that also kind of shows the ups and downs and the antics of this close-knit family. I think people will like that one.
Okay, what new shows and movies are you really excited about coming to Netflix this month?
Ooh, I loved the show called The Staircase. If anybody is a Netflix viewer and they watched Making a Murderer and they loved that, it was a huge hit, then the one you want to watch now is The Staircase. But there's also really kind of fun, light, romantic comedies. You want to see these during the summertime. There's a cute one called Set It Up. It stars Lucy Liu and Taye Diggs. I watched it with my teenage daughter. We both loved it. I love a good documentary, a good docu-series. And I'd like to recommend Bobby Kennedy for President, because this is the 50th anniversary right now this week of his passing. And this was so well done. They use all this amazing footage from back then, and you really get to understand the Bobby phenomenon and the legacy that he left. If you like foreign films, there's a great one called Sunday's Illness. There's just this really, really fun, crazy baking competition show called Nailed It. And we always have to have something for our Star Wars fans. Last Jedi, Episode 8, coming to Netflix in the month of June.
Okay. Which of our favorite stars have new shows and movies on Netflix?
Well, it's interesting because you see some really big stars now coming over doing original content for Netflix. There's a really cute comedy series called The Ranch. It stars Ashton Kutcher and Sam Elliott and Deborah Winger. And they're just the trio. It's a funny show. They're trying to keep this ranch going. So you see all the dynamics of the family. And also, you can see Kurt Russell in Miracle. That's one of those movies that if you have kids and you're having a sleepover, this is the movie to show. He plays the coach that takes that 1980 ice hockey team to Olympic gold. I remember when the real story happened. National Treasure, another great movie with John Voight and Nicolas Cage. And then the Academy Award winning The King's Speech. And if you didn't see this movie, definitely watch it. It stars Colin Firth, and he is, I mean, it's just an amazing acting performance.
Okay, so give us some tips on streaming Netflix while traveling this summer.
I think that's what's so different. You can download anything, like any of these movies or the series. You can download them to any of your, you know, your phone, your tablet. Take them with you. If you're in the back of a car, family's going on a vacation, a road trip, you can be watching whatever you want to watch. 30,000 feet in the air, I download all the time and take things with me and watch them as I'm traveling. And one of the things I really love about Netflix is that as you start to watch programs, you build your viewing profile. So it sees what you like, and it starts giving you all these suggestions, these recommendations. And I found new shows that I never would have looked for. I never would have, you know, clicked on them and watched them. But they recommend them to me because they know what I like.
Okay, and how do we set up Netflix? It's really easy, right?
It's amazingly simple. You just go to Netflix.com. You put in your email and your credit card information and your zip code, and you sign in, and you can put like four other people in your family on your account. I have my two sets of twins who are 13 and 15, and the good thing for a parent is I can see everything that they're watching. But we can watch what we want, when we want, and never again are we going to come home and say, wow, there's really nothing good on TV tonight, because now there always is something great.
All right. Joan London, thank you so much for hanging out with us today. We appreciate you.
My pleasure.
Coming up.